short video this week about a topic that can cause a lot of arguments between men and women, I think. The question is, who has it easier, men or women? Well, ask any woman and the answer is obvious, it's men. And you men probably think that women have it easier. But allow me to illustrate at least one very small way where you men do have it easier. And it came up recently for me. If you've watched my past videos, this, past few weeks, you know I recently had a birthday. And it also coincided with having to renew my driver's license. Without going into a bunch of boring details, the state has changed its policy here and requires you to jump through several hurdles when it's time to either get a new or renew your driver's license if you haven't done it yet under this new system. Basically, it's all part of making sure you are an American citizen, you live where you say you are. It's to avoid illegal immigrants or worse, terrorists from getting a phony ID. Plus, they've made our driver's licenses much more difficult to counterfeit, things like that. Basically, you're confronted with like a Chinese menu. You need one from column A and one from column B and two from column C. All these pieces of evidence to prove you are who you say you are. Column A is your proof that you're an American citizen. For most people, that would be your government-issued birth certificate. If you happen to have one, your U.S. passport. Column B is proof of your Social Security number. All citizens in the U.S. have one. Most people would bring in their government-issued Social Security card, or you could. There are certain tax documents that show both your name and your Social Security number. That would be sufficient. Column C is proof that you live where you say you live, and that has to be only certain things. It could be your official voter registration card, or it could be anything that the government has mailed to you that has your name and address, or it could be a bank statement or a utility bill, as long as it has your name and your address. Now here's the catch. Your name on all of these documents has to be the same. Now for men, easy peasy, no problem, because their name pretty much doesn't change. If you're a woman who has been married, who has taken her husband's last name, like me, guess what? They aren't gonna match. So, if you've been married and you're a woman and you've changed your name, you have to also bring in your marriage certificate. If you're a woman like me who's been married more than once, that would mean bringing in any and all marriage certificates. Thankfully, I only had one prior marriage, but it was going to mean having to bring in both of them, and it was going to be a major nightmare for me because I don't have that marriage certificate anymore. That was a really long time ago in a different state. I don't live there anymore. So I was going to have to contact the state where I used to live, fill out paperwork, pay them some money, request my certificate, wait for them to mail it to me before I could then go and get my license. Major hassle. I was lucky. I happened to have a U.S. passport. And because Newfer Blatts and I have been married for so long, everything matches. My passport, my Social Security card, my voter's registration card, my bank statement, they all had the same name, and so it wasn't too much of a problem for me, thank goodness. But it does illustrate, in a small way, one reason why men have it easier than women, because men rarely change their names for any reason. What do you think? Who has it easier, men or women? Trust me, men do. Anyway. Just a quick video this week. That's all for now. Come back and see me.
See ya.